Welcome to the Chef's Kitchen Healthy Fine Dining Series. I'm your host, Nicole Gaffney, and we're here today with St. Luke's Monroe Campus, featuring chefs and doctors working together to create healthy new menu options to be featured at the restaurants. And joining me in the kitchen today is the executive chef of the Split Rock Resort, Chef Susan Nordt, as well as Jill D'Alessandro from St. Luke's Monroe Campus. Welcome, both of you.
Thank you.
Of course. Well, what are we making today?
So today we're going to make a salmon. This is actually a Faroe Island salmon with a winter pesto with a basmati lentil rice pilaf laced with some cranberries over some greens.
Yum. Why don't we get started?
Okay, so we're going to start with the lentils and the rice. They take a little longer to cook. Mm-hmm. So would you like to start to peel?
Sure.
Those are big carrots.
Yeah. Nice and healthy.
Yeah, definitely. Now, do you like to cook a lot, Jill?
I do like to cook, yes.
Great.
I like to cook, not a baker.
Yeah. So you like to just have fun and throw things in the pan.
Yes, definitely.
Me too.
And cooking with fresh vegetables and fruits are my passion, yes.
Oh, good. Well, tell us a little bit more about what you do at St. Luke's.
So I'm the Vice President of Patient Care Services. Mm-hmm. My role really is to help facilitate collaboration and teamwork with our patients mm-hmm. and our managers and our physicians.
Fantastic.
So what we're going to do is start the lentils with an actual basic mirepoix, which is onion, celery, and carrots. We're going to put a little olive oil in the pan. We're going to get the aromatics going mm-hmm. so that the lentils will actually cook with all of that flavor. We're going to cook the rice separately because they have a little slightly different cooking time. And then we're going to mash them together to bring in the color and the different flavors.
Great. Beautiful. Now, you're a nurse.
Correct. I am a nurse, yes.
But you didn't start out that way.
I did not, no.
A previous career before that.
Well, I've always been in healthcare. Nursing is a second career for me. And I got into healthcare because I really just wanted to help take care of people and make
that.
A difference.
Yeah.
So nursing just seemed natural, and St. Luke's just felt like a right fit. It's always been a family type atmosphere at St. Luke's.
Definitely. That's so nice. Did you want her to chop up the celery also, or the carrots?
Maybe just wash it off.
Okay. Okay. Very important to always wash your vegetables.
Yes,
a lot of people skip that step.
Okay, so I'm going to start with the onions in here.
All right, now it's just some olive oil.
Just a little olive oil
right
on the bottom.
Nice, heart healthy oil.
There's a lot of nutrients that are packed behind different foods mm-hmm. that many people don't realize. It's great when they're actually when it can actually taste good and be good for you.
Absolutely, like an onion, for example. Mm-hmm. People don't realize how nutritious an onion is. Cooked and raw.
That's true. Very true. So everything, all the ingredients that we have today are definitely filled with antioxidants and fiber. Mm-hmm. Everything except maybe the basmati rice is a low glycemic. Mm-hmm. This is really a healthy dish all the way around.
We have a salad bar at our campus.
Your cafeteria.
Our cafeteria,
ridiculous.
Yes. Our chefs really focus on incorporating fresh vegetables and mm-hmm. fruits on our salad bar. We have an organic garden. It's the Rodell Organic Garden at our Anderson campus.
That is so cool.
This is our first year that we're actually having winter crops.
Oh,
so
wow.
That's really exciting.
That's really exciting.
And you can really tell, and it does make a difference when our chefs incorporate that into the meals. We feed those fruits and vegetables to our patients as well.
Wow, that's such a great commitment to patient care. It really is. So you have carrots, celery, and onion, the full mirepoix working over here.
That's right. And then at the same time, we're going to start the rice in the back. And then we're just going to start with a little drop of olive oil for that as well.
Okay. You like to toast the rice a little bit first? I do, too.
I do. I know it's not necessarily a traditional with the basmati rice, but I think it brings out a little bit more nuttiness to
it
and the flavor.
And basmati has such a great flavor for a rice to begin with. Those nice, long, thin granules.
Agreed. Totally agreed.
So you don't even measure at all.
So, well, I usually eyeball.
Yeah, that's good, though.
That's my kind of cooking.
Really the mark of a good chef, I think. So you're just going to toast that up a little bit.
So just going to give it, not even to give it too much color, just a little bit of to bring out the nuttiness in the grains of the rice.
Sure.
We'll be back with more from St. Luke's University Health Network. We now return to the Chef's Kitchen with St. Luke's University Health Network.
The restaurant that this particular item is on is the Split Rock Grill, mm-hmm. and that is more of a mid-range price menu. We we also have a little more higher end restaurant, which is not exactly white tablecloth, but again, it's a family resort, so where you can go after you've been spend the day on the beach and still enjoy maybe a little bit more flavor profile, a little bit more dynamics to the menu, rather than more kid-friendly. So we still offer kid-friendly meals, but it's more for the family who's looking for a little something extra.
Nice. So you have a little something for everyone.
We also have a pizza court.
Everybody loves pizza.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, they certainly do. You can't go wrong with that.
No.
So this is just a basic chicken stock that we've prepared ahead of time.
Okay. And you make all of that in-house?
We do.
Restaurant? That's great.
We do.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
You can really see how the rice is toasted and obviously
and
very hot pan.
Yes.
Smells fabulous.
And how do you determine how much liquid that you need for the rice, since you didn't really measure?
So in my experience, I usually do a 1-1.5 ratio. Mm-hmm. So it's usually 1-2, but I want to keep this a little bit tender still. Tender but firm.
Yeah.
I want to have a little bite to the rice still. I know this isn't the best looking, but it works the best. So I'm actually just going to cover this up and let this cook for a while.
Really? So for rice, you always use tin foil rather than a lid?
It depends. This will seal much tighter than a lid, and it's usually always there. So, depending on a busy kitchen, you can't always find the right lid for the right pot.
Right.
So then, while these are softening up, we are going to add the lentils to this.
Okay. And these are just green lentils?
These are just regular green lentils. Mm-hmm. Yes.
I love lentils because it's a nice legume, but they cook so quick. You don't have to soak them first.
Right. And legumes are great because they give us protein in our diet, which
and
is so
fiber.
Important. And fiber, yes, definitely.
Yeah, they're one of my favorite things to eat, too. They're so satisfying, you know?
And then the same chicken stock, we're just going to add to that
great.
As well.
So we're imparting a lot of flavor
every
step of the way, which is very important when we're making healthy food. We're not adding a lot of extra fat.
Right.
And this recipe is going to be featured on your menu.
It is.
Great.
Well, we should have a new menu coming out featuring this dish and a lot of revamped items in January.
That's always fun when you get to redo the menu.
It is. It gives both the staff and the patrons a different view of a favorite place, right?
Right,
so
totally.
You come to work every day, and you know it's nice to have a little more creativity and be able to prepare dishes that people are really going to enjoy.
Now, how long do both of these take to cook?
They take about this size portion probably takes 15 minutes to cook.
That's
so
really,
that's why we
really
started
quick.
With that. Yes,
yeah.
So that's why we started there as well. From there, we're going to move on to preparing the winter pesto.
Got some beautiful greens over here.
So there's a variety of greens here. Each one is similar but has different flavor profiles. So we have some baby kale
that we're
going to use.
Kale's gotten so wildly popular in recent
years. And you can cook it so many different ways or prepare it so many different ways.
Did you ever think to make pesto with it?
I never did. I've made pesto with basil before, but never with kale.
Right. And is that spinach?
And this is baby spinach as well. And then we have baby arugula. And we use the baby items because they have a subtle flavor.
Yeah.
They're still tender, and no one flavor will overpower the other, but together they make a very appealing dish. Then then we're going to start with a couple cloves of garlic.
Got to have garlic and pesto.
Absolutely.
Definitely.
And then instead of the nuts, due to a lot of allergies, we are using pumpkin seeds.
Fantastic.
This time, which also are very, an excellent source of vitamins and minerals
super
antioxidants.
Healthy,
absolutely.
That's such a great idea. You know, you see more and more people with nut allergies and all kinds of food allergies today. So to be able to make something that is so inclusive and everyone can have is really great.
Okay, then we have some Parmesan cheese. We're gonna do a little salt and pepper. And then we're gonna blend this all together with some olive oil.
Wow, I love how you have such big granules of salt in there. Beautiful.
We'll be back with more from St. Luke's University Health Network. We now return to the Chef's Kitchen with St. Luke's University Health Network.
And now we have Ashley Lyon coming on. She's the marketing director over at the Split Rock Resort. So come on in. But we have this pesto working.
Tell you a little bit about the resort.
Yeah, please do.
So Split Rock Resort is a four-season, family-friendly resort. It's a great place to come. We have a bunch of activities all year round.
Nice.
There's our indoor water park, our arcade, cool. Our bowling alley, our movie theater. All of those four are open to the public, which is great if you just want to come for a day trip.
Yeah.
And then you won't leave hungry, no matter what.
If you
haven't
like
heard
it.
About our restaurants, we also have a few bars where we have live entertainment. And on top of that, if you want to stay the night, we have a variety of lodging. So if you're looking for a romantic getaway, come stay in our Willowbrook Suites. They have a fireplace, a giant jacuzzi tub. And then if you're looking to stay with your family in the center of the action, we have our Galleria.
Cool.
Looking for something a little rustic, you want a nice view of the lake, you can always stay in our lodge.
Wow, so it sounds like you really have a little bit of something
for everyone. A
little
bit of everything, yes.
That's so great.
And then on top of that, we have weekly activities. Mm-hmm. So we have turtle races and bingo, which
cool.
is something that's pretty unique.
Yeah.
And we also have beach access to our lake and miniature golf. So no matter the year, the time of the year, you're good to go. We're in between ski slopes and golf courses.
Sounds like you don't even need the ski slopes.
Right. You can just stay at the resort.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Sounds like a blast. Well, you're going to come back and taste with us at the end. We'll see you
Thank
there.
You. So now we just process this. And it doesn't take long. Just gonna add a little more olive oil. And we just want to get that great consistency. And that's done.
Gorgeous
color. We're gonna start on our pomegranate reduction.
So this is regular old store-bought pomegranate juice that anyone can buy?
We don't want to use too much. And then this is maybe one of the vices, but this is just because I want to reduce this and get a nice consistency on it. We're just going to put a couple spoons of sugar in it.
Which we're probably only going to be using a little bit of that on the plate, right?
Yes. So very, very
little. A little will go a long way.
And really, everything in moderation is
definitely
okay.
That's how I try to live.
Yes.
You know, you got to have a couple cookies every once in a while.
Definitely.
Especially this time of year. So is the rice, you think, almost done?
The rice is all set.
Wow.
And then we're just gonna start this.
So fast. So you're just gonna let that boil and boil and boil
and
until
boil until
like
all the water is absorbed.
Right.
This we're gonna, boil until that water is, until it's syrupy.
Awesome. Now, Jill, you must be so excited to be at the Monroe campus.
We are so excited to be there. You know, we came to the area because of our physicians and our patients really needing a service in this area.
Definitely.
Being part of a large network is so important because, you know, our goal is really to keep our patients close to home.
Of course.
But if they do require something in addition, a higher level of care, being part of a larger network just allows the patients to get that care and then return back to their homes.
So you have all of the St. Luke's resources right here in
we
Monroe
do.
County.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So what are we working on next?
Now we're going to work on the salmon. Salmon in itself is very good for you regardless. So
super
if you can't find wild, I think you're definitely okay to
now, I have
go
to
ahead
comment
and eat the salmon
your technique
anyway.
Here. We can't skip over this. You just pulled that skin off like it was nothing.
So it's actually a lot easier than you would think. All you need to do is start the fillet and go ahead and go under, and the hand that doesn't have the knife does much more work than the knife itself.
So you're kind of pulling on the skin?
Pulling on the skin and just kind of holding the knife in place. And we're just gonna salt and pepper this and season this a little bit, and we're gonna grill this. I'm gonna go ahead and
now this isn't what you're using at the restaurant.
No.
I didn't think so. That would be very time consuming.
It would indeed, yes.
But you have an actual grill, so you're grilling the salmon.
Yes.
Nice.
Yes.
It's fabulous that the restaurants are offering these types of meals because, you know, as nurses and doctors, we're always counseling our patients, you know, in the healthy way to eat. So when you go out to eat, sometimes you feel like you're not always eating as healthy. And nowadays, everyone, there's always an option.
Exactly. It's hard to go out to eat and feel like that Debbie Downer who wants to have something healthy.
Or just a salad.
Yeah, and ask for like a million substitutions. And then, you know, the servers get frustrated. The kitchen gets frustrated. So when you have something that's already in place on the menu that people know that they can get and that it's doctor approved, St. Luke's Hospital approved, that's fantastic.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
We'll be back with more from St. Luke's University Health Network. We now return to the Chef's Kitchen with St. Luke's University Health Network.
Now this is just the toasted ground coriander.
Oh, you can really just smell that as soon
and
as it cooks.
Some chopped fresh thyme.
Wow, that's so fragrant. It almost smells lemony.
That's the coriander that's coming out with all the other aromatics.
I would just eat that as soup.
So then we're going to chop up a shallot. So it's a little less, this is the cross between an onion and garlic. Mm-hmm. And it's not as harsh as either of them.
I love shallots. They get nice and
I do too, yes.
Sweet and mild.
Yeah. You cook with them a lot?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I do.
Okay, so we're gonna start with another drop of olive oil.
They don't make you cry either.
Yeah, they don't. You chop enough of them, they'll make you cry.
Yeah.
You know, the trick to not crying when you chop onions is just don't form an emotional bond.
Oh.
So do you want to get color on the shallots, or do you just want to sweat them out a bit?
We can put a little color to them, but we don't want them to be too
overpowering.
Over color.
Down a little bit.
Lower. Right.
We got nice caramelization. Mm-hmm. Ooh, now you can really smell them too. Mm-hmm.
Then what we're going to do is add, again, the same components that we put in for the winter pesto.
Right, so we're kind of just carrying those flavors over.
Absolutely. The pesto that will be on the fish will be just a little, just to add a little color and a little flavor to it.
Nice. This is great too if somebody wants to make this recipe at home. Mm-hmm. You're just shopping for all the same ingredients. You
absolutely.
Don't need to get a million different things, which is really important for home cooks. And the salmon looks great in that little grill. I'm kind of impressed at how well
it's it's actually almost finished, so that's terrific. But I'm just gonna add a little bit of white wine.
All right.
And let that add just a little flavor to that.
Sure.
And eating healthy is just, it just makes you feel better. It just helps you constantly, you know, do the right things. It's the
Definitely.
First step.
Definitely.
When you eat better, then you don't mind exercising.
It's true.
It gives you
just
energy.
You feel better.
Yeah.
And like you were saying before, you know, rather than having to just eat a plain chicken breast, I mean, if you're doing that every single day, it's going to be really easy to not eat healthy.
Right.
Because you're just going to want to indulge.
Right.
But when you have food that's this vibrant and
right.
colorful and has so much flavor going on,
it makes you want to move.
Okay, so now we're just going to marry the lentils with the rice that we cooked. We're going to add a little bit of dried cranberry to it just to sweeten it a little, give it a little color.
It's a nice natural way to get some sweetness in there.
Mm-hmm. And cranberries are very good for you too. I mean, as they dry, they become a little bit more, a little sweeter. The natural mm-hmm. sugars come out, but.
The rice looks perfect. I'm so impressed with how good of a job you did with that, because to me, I think rice is one of the hardest things to nail to get perfect in the kitchen.
It definitely can be, yes.
So I'm always so impressed when somebody can get it right, especially when they don't measure.
And it was easy.
Yeah.
She made it look really easy.
Now, do you like to cook the salmon all the way through, or do you like it a little rare in the middle?
I like it just a little rare.
Mm-hmm.
Then it's not too dry.
Right.
Yeah, exactly. It has a nice texture that way too.
So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna try to get some of the moisture out.
Okay. They cooked up so quickly too.
The greens are very mm-hmm. fast, and you notice they still have a component of green to them.
Yes.
So you don't wanna overdo it too
Definitely.
Much.
Definitely. Important for flavor and
Absolutely.
The nutrients also.
Okay, then we're actually gonna put the live salmon right on top.
Very nice.
Then we're going to use a little bit of a trade secret, just for a little presentation.
A little ring mold biscuit cutter.
Mm-hmm. Looks beautiful.
It does. Now, do you find January winter time is your busiest time, or more so in the summer?
It actually varies. The summer is pretty steady, but there are a lot of times in January and February that we're actually very busy. So then what we're gonna do is just garnish this right across.
Oh, it's such a pretty color.
All those greens are still in there, and everything has the nutrients. Still, we didn't cook anything out of them. And we're just going to garnish with a little bit of pumpkin seed.
Nice. Good texture in there. Mm-hmm.
And a little bit of cranberry. And we're just going to lace the glaze right over the top.
A lot of different flavors going on here. I like it.
But nothing too overpowering.
No. It all seems to work really well. Mm-hmm. Can't wait to taste it. Yum. That pomegranate smells really good.
Okay, and that's that.
Beautiful. Let's bring it over to the table. I can't wait to taste. Thanks for coming back and joining us, Ashley. Here's a fork.
Let's
dig in. I'm excited. Don't be shy.
Really good.
This is fabulous.
Thank you.
So good. The salmon is perfectly cooked and buttery, and that pesto is really awesome.
Thank you.
You would never know that there's pumpkin seeds and all those different greens in there.
Really good.
Yeah. It really does have a texture, though. It's fabulous. Thank you.
Very excited to come try this on location at Split Rock Resort.
Yeah.
And Jill, thank you so much to you and St. Luke's Monroe campus. It's been a pleasure having you guys on the show today.
Thank you.